This EP scan demo analyzes a differential pair on an open source board and generates a report. Let's start by importing an open source board file, the OpenRex. Let's start EP scan. We will navigate to the location where we store the ODB++ file. Here, we have located the file. Click Open. I'll add underscore demo as the name of the project. Click Create after done naming. The layout import process will start. Before we start analyzing the traces and the board layout, it is important to verify the substrate properties. Having confirmed the substrate stackup, the design import is finished. In this demo, we will examine a PCIe differential pair. The complete PCIe underscore TX differential pair has DC blocking capacitors. Let's create a composite net and add the capacitors. A composite net is the combination of nets and components. We will use the icon on the left to create the composite net. I will also add underscore demo after the name so we are consistent. And click OK. Here is where we add the DC blocking capacitors. The value of the capacitor is 100 nanofarad. After setting the capacitance value for both capacitors, the composite nets with the component is ready for analysis. The composite net is in the net class. We will add it to the test plan by clicking the down arrow to determine whether the differential impedance is within the specification. We are assigning a PCIe Gen 3 impedance specification to the composite net. To do so, we select the net and click on the specification icon on the left. And click on Assign Specification. We will navigate to the PCIe DiffTX demo. As shown, the target differential impedance range is 85 ohms plus and minus 5%. Let's assign this specification to the test plan and run the test plan. After the simulation is completed, we can see sections of the traces that pass the specification in green. Because of the DC blocking capacitor, we should expect the insertion loss at DC to have a large negative dB value. The return loss should be 0 dB at DC. Let's look at the insertion loss. As shown, the insertion loss has a large negative dB value at DC. The return loss, as expected, is 0 dB at DC. We can run an I-diagram analysis. Knowing the data rate of the PCIe channel, we will change the data rate to 8 gigabit per second in the text field and select the demo composite net. Because it is a working design, we expect the I to be open at 8 gigabit per second. Sure enough, the I is open. Other than the signal integrity metrics, EPScan also shows you locations of the VSW resonances and return path discontinuities. After the fabrication process, the rectangular trace cross-section becomes a trapezoid. The impact of the trace edgeback can be included in our simulation. Specifically, we can enter the edge angle for the traces. We will click on View Substrate to change the edge angle. The edge angle is in the units of degrees and is the rightmost column in the substrate editor. We will enter 60 degrees as the edge angle. As we save and run the test plan again, we expect the edgeback to increase the impedance. As expected, including the edgeback increases the impedance. With the edgeback included, we no longer meet the spec. Let's generate a report to keep a record. The report contains the pass-fail status of the test plan, the stackup information, and other analysis results. This concludes the EPScan demo. Tell your colleagues about EPScan's quick and reliable signal integrity simulation.